Let's take a look at the top 10 plays.
Number one, Indiana and Northwestern. Now, this is an interception. This is a one-handed interception by Kyle Queiro.
Show off.
This is just no simple one-handed interception. He had no choice.
Oh.
He had to do the one-handed grab because he's got a cast on the other hand. I got it. Northwestern wins 24-14.
Sports Centers.
About a yard and a half to go here for Indiana. Now Lego's going to throw for it on fourth down. Looking, now he dumps it off. It's caught, but short of the first down. Well short. Page made the catch, and he's wrapped up right away by Kyle Queiro.
Hogan out. Intercepted. Picked off by Queiro.
And instead of trying to take it to the house, he shut it down so they can come out and take a knee.
DiNucci to throw. Rolling. Firing. Intercepted! Queiro has it! And Kyle Queiro will give Northwestern a victory with that interception.
Kyle Queiro, a guy who we thought got nicked up at the beginning of this game. Just a great read on the route right there. Puts his foot in the ground, cuts underneath.
Dobbs is going to pass. Completes it out near the 40-yard line to his tight end, Ethan Wolf, who's tackled immediately for Corey Davis. Rebion Franklin in the flat. Very little room to go after the catch. Kyle Queiro, the strong safety, making the tackle.
You sealed the win against Stanford with an interception. You sealed the bowl win with an interception. But the one against Indiana, the one-handed interception with a club on the other hand, is, I think, the one that everyone remembers. Honestly, how many times have you watched that back?
I'd say probably under 10, to be
under
honest.
Under 10?
Yeah.
Really?
Outside of that day, of course.
Well, that day counts. How many times you watched it that day?
That day, maybe 1,000. It was sent to me so many times.
Man, I am good.
But it's good to just keep confidence up. And everybody on that day got to see what I could do and what our defense as a whole is capable of, holding one of the Big Ten's best passing teams. I think they were number one at the time. It's only 12 points. That was a good day for us. And just moving forward, hoping to make good plays like that as a team, and mostly as a secondary.
Safety Kyle Queiro, have a great year.
I appreciate it.
Clean pocket, but it's picked. Intercepted right around the goal line by Kyle Queiro, the senior.
So you want your seniors to come up with big plays, especially an experienced senior like Kyle Queiro. He did a nice job of baiting Ganji. And faded back and made a nice play. Nice job by Queiro reading that quarterback.
They have to
come. Yeah.
Give Jason
Bumble. Bumble recovered.
All around the guy next to you right now. This is the guy that you've been working with. You guys are getting you better. I know you're not going to let that guy next to you down.
No.
But right now, 30 minutes, the guy next to you.
Jonathan Taylor stretching to the outside. He's wrestled down inside the five.
Barkley dropped for a loss. Kyle Queiro.
Dumps it off underneath to Antrim. Good open field tackle.
Yeah, he loves what he's seen so far. Croft going to try to go back to the air on a deep ball, and oh, he underthrew it. It's picked off. Intercepted by Kyle Queiro.
Surprising college football.
coming up the tackle.
Lee on third down, pressure coming, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Kyle Queiro, who takes it out of bounds inside the 30-yard line.
Queiro did a nice job of undercutting this ball.
Second and 12, off play action. Lee looking deep for Morgan. Jump ball, and it's incomplete. Queiro in the area. Huskers have all three timeouts. Lee, and it's intercepted. Picked off for the second time today by Kyle Queiro, and now it's Northwestern with a chance to score before halftime. Third down and 7 at the 48. Lee, over the middle, tipped and incomplete. Queiro with an outstanding play. Spielman was that close to a touchdown.
Spielman got on top. Queiro undercut it and got his hand on the ball. Or that's 6 quick. Really well defended. Ball needed to come up just a tad more. Just a fingernail more.
That's an outstanding play by Kyle Queiro. And winding down to tie a game in the fourth. Draw play Ozigbo. Met by Queiro and driven back. Excellent play by the safety. Third and 5. No pressure. Lee almost intercepted again. Queiro nearly had another pick. Fourth and 11. Ball game right here. Lee. Pass deflected, incomplete. And Northwestern wins it in overtime. History made in Lincoln. The first team in FBS history to win 3 straight in overtime.
I think both Godwin and Kyle have really grown. I've really been impressed with their maturity. I think they've done a terrific job leading these last couple of years. They learned from some great ones, too, and they're fortunate for that. But they're both playing at a high level. Both guys, I think, are just outstanding teammates and have very bright futures. I think both are going to get an opportunity, and if they get an opportunity, I think they're going to play for a long time on Sunday because they've both got different skill sets, but they've got, I think, Sunday talent. And definitely Sunday attitude and work ethic. So excited to have him for a couple more games. And then Kyle, you know, just it's a family affair there, you know, with both. I had the privilege to coach both he and his brother Cam and you know, his mom and dad. It's just been great. It seems like yesterday that I walked into his house in New Jersey. So it's an emotional week for me. You know, I go back with a lot of these guys to start in the recruiting process when they were 15, 16 years old. To see the men that they've become while going through our program, I'm just really proud of them. They come from great families, so we're a big leg up when they first get here. But just very proud of the men that they've become and excited not only for the last few games with them, but also excited for their futures.
The coaches said it. Everybody says it. It goes more quickly than you think it will. Has it felt that way to you?
In terms of finally getting to a position in which I feel like I'm making a larger impact and influence. Feels like I finally gained my grounds and gotten past just getting my feet wet. And then, you know, you blink and you're towards the 11th and 12th games of the season. So just got to do the most with what I have left.
This is for Kyle. Purdue threw it 61 times on Saturday. That's the most any team has thrown against you this year. What was it like in the defensive backfield facing that?
You know, honestly, I wasn't that happy. Because, you know, they threw it a bunch of times. I didn't feel like I got enough opportunities myself. But a lot of those throws were checkdowns and dump throws. I think they threw the ball 61 times, 398 or so yards. It's like 6 yards an attempt, and on completions a little bit over 10 yards an attempt, mostly just checkdowns and then run for a few yards after that. Their longest completion was 35 yards, which that may have been that may have been the fake punt. I could be mistaken, but either way, I'm just saying a lot of it was, you know, dinks and dunks. So with the defensive line, the front 7 playing the way that they're playing, we need to understand that we're going to get a lot of passes from a lot of teams. Especially in this season, towards the second half, teams have constantly just abandoned the running game. They only ran the ball for 40 yards and less than 2 yards a carry. So with that understanding, we know on the back half of our team that we're going to get attacked, and we have been all year. And, you know, it doesn't help our stats, but in a way, numbers are for losers because we only gave up 13 points as a whole. So, yeah.
Kyle, you've seen four of your teammates called for targeting this year. And since you're out there in situations in open field a lot where you have to make a quick decision, has it changed the way you play or think through a play at all? Do you have to be more tentative?
That's actually a tough question to answer because on one end, you know, coaches and players talk about, you know, we want to play free without constrictions and just allow us to make plays because this is the things that we've been doing our whole lives. But we just understand that there's stipulations and regulations, boundaries that are now on our game, and it's for the betterment of it. So with that, you just kind of take it and understand it and try to play within, you know, that structure. I don't think anybody's necessarily been just irate over the rulings. It's just, man, sometimes wrong place, wrong time, and we're trying to be football players, but we're also trying to be safe. So,
all three of you maybe could answer, what does it mean to be ranked in the top 25, and especially after your start that you had? Does it give you a little extra incentive to keep it going?
I don't look at rankings at all. We know what we have in our locker room. We know what we have in this room, and whatever they think of us outside of it doesn't change anything.
Unfortunately, I might say the opposite. as a senior and, you know, a leader in the defensive back group, you know, I just challenged our guys in our room that, you know, this is going to be our last opportunity as seniors, and we want to go out not only on top every single week, but also just put Northwestern on the platform even further for years to come and just continue to gain respect for the program. And Coach Fitz talked about, you know, potentially getting bored with winning. I wanted to make it clear that it needs to be a habit. So, and that it just needs to be an infectious, contagious thing that, you know, it's hard to win in the Big Ten, and we need to continue doing it. Won't you follow me into the jungle?